Hello and welcome to Automate Code. Today we are going to discuss some basics of computer. So basics of computer means we will introduce ourselves with different kind of terms that is used while you deal with computer. So it will the discussion will be about computer software, hardware, input device, output device, what is computer, how you can use computer easily. So that are the topics I will be covering. That will be all about computer basics. So I have a slide here. Let me follow from this slide, and I will be going through each slide, and also after that I will be going through some other topics that I have intended to cover. Now, first of all, what is computer? So before we start learning QA, it is important for us, first try to go through what is computer. So computer, if you take a look in the definition here I have in the screen, a device that computer, especially a programmable electronic machine that performs high speed mathematical or logical operations, or that assembles, stores, correlates, or otherwise process information. Very simple, computer is a device that do computation. Computation means that does calculation. So calculation, you are watching a video, or you are watching a movie, or you are browsing in the internet. In the background, actually what is happening, all the operations happening is calculations. Computer is calculating, and by calculating actually it is processing data, and by processing data it is actually giving you the output, like watching video or browsing in the internet. Everything is calculation. In the background actually computer is doing some operations, mathematical operations. By doing mathematical operations, it is producing meaningful data to us. It is enabling browsing, internet browsing to us. So everything is calculation that computer is doing. Okay, so that is what computer is doing. Now computer, two terms you will need to familiarize yourself when you are working with computer. One is computer hardware, another one is computer software. Computer hardware is the devices or parts that you can see, that you can feel, that you can touch. It is just like if you compare human body is a hardware. Okay, inside human body you have life. Okay, so if you compare it like human body is a hardware. Computer monitor, computer CPU, computer mouse, keyboard, everything is a hardware. Now what is software? Software is like human body. When human body has life, then human body is, it can do whatever it likes. If there is no life, then it cannot do anything. So computer software is just like life of computer. Without software, hardware cannot do anything. So everything computer hardware is doing by software. Software is a set of instruction that actually does particular, a set of instruction that particularly perform an operation. Okay, now computer hardware, there are different kind of hardware, like monitor, that is the another name of monitor is VDU, display unit. So monitor, projector, everything is a output device, or display unit. So inside, can you see this box? This is CPU. Inside CPU there are different kind of motherboard, hard drive, different kind of hardware inside this CPU, and then this is keyboard. So monitor is the output device. Whatever computer is doing, whatever we are saying, it is coming out of our mouth. So our mouth is a, in terms like it is a output device. Again, we are listening by our ear. So ear is an input device. Okay, so Monitor actually is used to show you the calculation that CPU does, and keyboard is an input device, because we are typing something, we are inputting instructions, we are inputting our expression to computer by using keyboard. Okay, mouse is an input device, because by mouse we are giving input signal to the computer. Printer is an output device, we are printing computer processed data by printer. Now scanner is an input device, by scanner we input images to the computer, we scan images to the computer. Then what is computer software? I already discussed computer software is the life of computer. By using computer software, actually we are activating the hardware, and hardwares are working by using the softwares. Now computer softwares, like it is a set of instruction, as I said. Some example of computer software is Microsoft Word, Microsoft PowerPoint, or Microsoft Excel. All of them are software. Okay, and then let's say I have already told you what is input devices. Input device are the devices that is being used for inputting instruction to the computer. Keyboard, mouse, they are input device, but scanner again is an input device. Digital camera is input device, because by digital camera we can input images to the computer. Now computer output device is monitor, printer, because by monitor and printer computer is displaying its processed result. Okay, now inside, if you have a computer, previously if you have a desktop computer, you have like a monitor, and beside monitor you have a tower. Inside tower, what we are calling a CPU. Inside CPU we have different kind of devices, different kind of circuits, and different kind of chips. One of the main circuit inside the CPU is motherboard. Inside motherboard, actually different kind of RAM and other chips are integrated. So motherboard is a motherboard that is inside the CPU, where all of the other parts like RAM, processor, all other circuits resides in the motherboard. Then we have memory. So let's say you are taking food. So when you are taking food, you are taking food to the plate, and from plate you are eating. So when computer works with a software, let's say you are running Microsoft Word in your computer, so that Microsoft Word takes some place in memory, and from memory CPU is accessing Microsoft Word to work. So memory is when you are running something in the computer, those to run those software, they need to be stored somewhere. So that type of memory is called memory. That is where we are referencing as memory. So memory is when computer running a software, memory is used. When computer is let's say you are watching movie, then memory is used. Okay, when you are watching. Then storage device, let's say you have some movies stored in your computer, you have some images stored in your computer that you are not watching at this point, but those images are stored somewhere in your computer. Later on you can watch it. So for storing images or data, you use storage device. Okay, when you are reading something from a storage device, then it is coming to the memory. Okay, then input device, we have already discussed what is input device, output device, and software. What happens when a PC is powered on? With a simple push of button, your computer comes to life and it starts executing programs that is stored in its memory or in its storage device. Okay, now that is what I wanted to discuss in this short video. What is computer, or how it works? There are some questions here and related answers are also here. I will say, you go through these answers, and if you have any question you can ask me later on. But at this point, let me quickly see some definition here. Internet. So internet, what is internet? Internet is interconnected computers. So interconnected computers, it could be in a building, it could be in a city, it could be in a country, it could be in a continent. So the computers, millions of computers throughout the world are connected through internet. Okay, so we have already discussed CPU, desktop. Desktop is a computer like where you have a monitor and then you have CPU and keyboard, all that stuff. But we have another types of computer that is called laptop. In laptop, actually, everything is integrated in a small part, and it's pretty light to carry. And then file, you have file folder, files. I will discuss in detail what is file and folder, but let me show you what is file and folder. Okay, so if you go to my computer, let's say this is my computer. Now, can you see? This is a folder, this is a folder, this is a folder, right? Because inside folder you can store multiple file. This is a file. Okay, if you open this one, it will open a program called PowerPoint, Microsoft PowerPoint. Then if you open this folder, you have multiple files. Some of the files are PowerPoint, some of the files are PDF, some of the files are image. So a folder actually can contain multiple files. Normally files has an extension. Some of the files has extension called .xlsx. This is an Excel file. Some of the file has .png. Can you see this? This is an extension. This is an image file. Okay. And some of the files, can you see it has JPG? They are image too. Some of the files has .pps, PPTX extension. That is a PowerPoint file. So every file has an extension. Okay, let me go back to the slide and move forward from there. Now let me go back where I was in the discussion. Now folder, we have discussed file and folder, and then hyperlink. Okay, so now what is hyperlink? What is icon? What is input? What is hyperlink is, let's say if you browse to a site, so we are now in Google. Okay, now can you see? You cannot do anything with this text. This is just for view. But if you click on this one, it will bring you another page. So this is called hyperlink. Okay, so hyperlink is a link where if you click, it will bring you another page. So this is called hyperlink. Okay, now let me go back to the slide. Let's see if I have any other thing that I need to discuss from there. I think we have covered pretty much. Okay, let's see. I have some other thing here. Menu. What is menu? Okay, now menu, can you see here, like in this page? Actually, let me go to a site here. Let me go to qaquestions.org, and in qaquestions.org, if you take a look here, can you see when you hover over any of these, a set of items comes up, right? So this is a menu where each menu has some sub items. Okay, remember this is called menus. Okay, now let me go to operating system. Okay, operating system is operating system is, as I said, human body has life. When there is life, then human body, he can do whatever he likes. But for a computer, operating system is just like life. When there is an operating system in a computer system, then that computer can work. So if there is no operating system, that computer the computer will not work. So operating system is a set of huge set of instructions which actually is used to run a computer. Okay, then let's see what else we have here. RAM. So RAM and ROM, I will discuss it in another slide. Let me go to another slide where I will be discussing another topic. Now, I will discuss some other topics from here in this. I have a computer basics slides here, so I'll discuss it from here. Now, again, here I have discussed what is computer, and then we already discussed, if you take a look at this picture, a computer normally, input devices, mouse, keyboard, and then we have CPU, and then we have output devices. Inside CPU we have processor, we have ROM, RAM, and then we have CD-ROM, HDD, floppy drive, okay, and then we have AGP. AGP is used to produce video. Actually AGP is, by AGP, you know, computer process their output and put it in this monitor or projector, okay. This is AGP. AGP is used to process data for monitor. And then we have two types of memory. Remember, we have discussed memory, two types of memory, ROM and RAM. ROM is read-only memory, so it is some permanent programs or instructions that when computer manufacture, when they prepare a computer, they write some permanent program in ROM. Okay, this is permanently written when computer is manufactured, when computer is prepared. Okay, and these programs, what it does, it helps computer, when you press the power button, it helps computer to start operations. Okay, there are some set of instructions in RAM that is permanently written that helps the computer to start up. Okay, and then let's say when computer starts, it starts with a black screen or blue screen. So that program is actually written in ROM. And then when computer starts, it goes to Windows. So when it goes to Windows, then actually, you know, Windows is loaded in RAM. So in RAM, when you run something, when you run Microsoft Word or when you watch a video, it takes memory. When you play computer games, it takes memory in RAM. And then when you are not playing that video game, when you are not watching that video, then that memory no longer exists in the RAM. So RAM is called random access memory, that is volatile. And when you are running some programs, let's say I'm browsing in the internet, now it is consuming some memory in RAM, and when I will close this page, the memory will be emptied out. Okay, so this is what RAM and ROM. And then we have HDD or hard drive, where we store images or videos permanently. And then we have CD-ROM. We know what is CD-ROM. When you previously, you know, in the past, when you watched movies from disk, we use CD-ROM to play you know, those videos. Let me go to the next video. Here are the picture of some computer devices. Now some input and output devices, some more input devices, and then we have here we have primary memory and secondary memory. Primary memory are RAM and ROM, that is, you know, that is used to run a program by computer. Okay, and secondary memory is where you store data. So this is just storage device. Primary memory is used to run a program. We have some other pictures here. I'll encourage you to go through these topics and go through these videos here. And I have, like, you know, when computer passes instructions from processor to memory, you know, it uses buses. So there is a common bus. Bus means, like, when you gas, when you have gas in your house, it comes by a pipe. So when computer passes instructions from one parts to another inside the CPU, it uses buses. So this is where buses. And I have some pictures here. I will encourage you to take a look. This is a pictures from a old computer, desktop computer. If you can take a look here, this is the motherboard that we have discussed previously. This is the power supply unit, and this is where we have the hard drive, floppy drive. This is the hard drive. This is the CD-ROM. Right. These cables are power supply cable. And then here there is a fan that is used for cooling inside the CPU. And can you see this big fan here? Under this big fan, there is a what is called? There is a There is the processor, and then can you see here? This is the AGP card, okay? And then can you see, you can see clearly now, this is the fan. Under this fan there is the processor, and here there is the RAMs, okay? So I will encourage you to go through this video, this lecture from here, and watch, get a preliminary idea what computer is. So I'll wrap up this session here, and I will be discussing some other topics in the class. So thank you for watching this video. I appreciate your time.